I'd like to thank organizers for invitation. My talk is somehow orthogonal to other talks, for example, previous talks. So I need some introduction. main object of birational algebraic geometry is classification of algebraic varieties, and a standard class of varieties are algebraic varieties over algebraically closed field. So today I assume that characteristic k is zero. It's always. But there are some variations. First is also quite standard is we may consider varieties over non-closed fields. So makes classification much more complicated and much more interesting. Another generalization is if you consider algebraic varieties with some group action. Provided, for example, X, and we fix some finite group and embedding this group in to automorphism group for variety. Here I suppose that J is finite. And the basic idea is that we have to consider, of course, we can consider mixed class, of course. We can consider here varieties over algebraically closed, but we can consider varieties with group action over non-closed fields. the basic idea is that we have to consider all these classes simultaneously and try to develop some technique which works in at least in not my all, but in many cases. Most interesting class is a class of rationally connected variety. X is rationally connected. I recall that variety is said to be rationally connected if it is covered by rational general points of X can be connected there is a rational curve sitting inside X such that it passes through both of these points. This class maximally is very, very close to rational ones. So this is, and this class has a very rich birational structure. For example, if you look at the group of birational automorphism, then, for example, for varieties which are not very close to rational, for example, for varieties of general type, this coincides with group of biregular automorphism of its canonical model. So it's typically it's finite for general type, but for rationally connected varieties, there is many choices. For example, if you consider, if you take X to be a projective plane, this group is called Cremona group. And this is infinite dimensional group. For example, it contains very huge group of polynomial automorphisms. And on the other hand, we have a lot of, there are aberrationally rigid varieties, super rigid. For them, this group is finite. For example, if we take X to be variety, a smooth variety, of dimension d plus 1 in p d, for example, quartic, sorry, quartic in p4.
Quartic means that d is equal to 4.
D is equal to 4. For example, x4 in p4. Smooth quartic. Then famous theorem of Iskowski-Marin says that this group is it's general. Then this group is trivial. In general case, it was proved by Puchlikov. So this is most interesting class of varieties to consider. We have Mori theory now in arbitrary dimension for varieties of this type. We can apply a minimal model program to X. First of course, we can make it projective and take resolution of singularities. In these cases, we need equivariant resolution of singularities. Then we apply equivariant and as output, we get so-called Mori fiber space, Mori Fana fiber space. this means that anti-canonical divisor of Y is relatively ample. Moreover, relative Picard number. If we have group action, then we should consider invariant Picard number equals 1. And third, we should consider varieties with singularities. Actually, Y has some very mild singularity, so-called terminal. And Q factorial. In the case of group action, we have to consider JQ factorial singularities. In dimension two, it means that Y should be smooth also. So it's. first example when that is a point. Then Y is a fun variety, but possibly singular. that this one anti-canonical device that. So the topic of this workshop is fun variety. so I think that. everybody should know minus kx, ky is ample. Not just over z is a point, so this just ample. And moreover, of course, we have these properties also. Thank you. This is already something, but not enough. Now, if you want birational classification, we should look at relations between the such models. I didn't say that this model is unique. So this model can be, these models can be birationally equivalent. First, typically this is the case, and also it can be so this model itself can have birational automorphism. The good example is the following. Look at let us look at this case. So our question is, we want to classify, look at the group birational automorphism of P2. This is automorphism. This is called Cremona over K, and K is algebraically closed. And I want to classify elements of order 2. Up to conjugacy. This means that we want to actually in an algebraic geometry language, this means that we want to classify such models. X is projective smooth rational surface and this element is an involution in the group of biregular automorphisms of this. So we want to classify such pairs up to we want to classify these elements up to conjugacy, so we want to classify these pairs up to equivariant birational equivalence. Next, we can run this program. And here, this model should be smooth. And we have only few possibilities here. This is a classical example of, this goes back to, I think, Castelnuovo. It says that we have the following. First, when, that is a point. Y is two-dimensional planar. Two-dimensional planar is called del Petri surface. Smooth. And moreover, invariant Picard is one. And up to birational equivalence, first, we have the following possibilities. First, of course, Y is P2. The standard thing and tau is linear. Here there are a lot of models. Next one, a little bit more interesting. Why is del Petri of degree 2? Del Petri of degree 2, if you look at the anti-canonical linear system, then it gives us a map which is fine of degree 2. And the branch. Oh, thank you. And branch divisor is a plain quartic. Next, why is del Pezzo of degree 2? Here we also have similar situation. We have a double cover of singular quadric in P3. Is branch divisor of degree 6. Yes?
I apologize about notation. This phi?
This is map given by correspondent linear system. Ah, yes, this is a linear system. Yes, yes. Yes.
And
yes, yes, yes. This is two-dimensional and gives the map of degree 2. And here, we have, of course, we have to define an evolution, but it's obvious. We have a Galois evolution here, as well as here. And the third one is so-called Dejean-Kier involutions. This involution is called Geyser involution. This involution is called Bertini involution. Very classical. And third class are involution of Dejean-Kier type. Actually, it's, here this is a point. This is a curve. Pardon?
Number 2 on degree 1 or?
Degree 2.
Also 2?
Del Pezzo, yes. Degree 1, but map of degree 2. So thank you. And of course, we can define it like this, but actually, it's better to fix some birational automorphism with A2, for example, and give it as a map y, xy. Tau is given by x, y over phi of x, where phi is polynomial of degree 2g plus 1, without multiple roots. and this is a complete list. And actually, it's easy to see that all these involutions are not conjugate to each other. Why? Because actually, argument is very easy. We can look at a fixed point locus everywhere. For example, here, the fixed point locus is isomorphic to this curve, branch curve. And this is a curve of degree 4, so this is curve of genus 3 and non-hyperelliptic. Actually, it's well known. So fixed point locus here is a curve of positive degree. Suppose it, for example, there is a birational map from here to here. But here, such fixed point locus is consists of rational curves. Curve for positive genus cannot be hidden after birational transformations. So this is very easy. As well as here. Here we have a curve of degree 4, which is also non-hyperelliptic. And here, fixed point locus consists of hyperelliptic curve of genus G. So all of them are different. So we see that in at least in dimension 2, this program works well and gives us a very reasonable classification. of course, there are a lot of other questions here about conjugacy and invariance. Let me list some methods to distinguish birational equivalence classes. First method, I think that the best one is this method of maximal singularities. It goes back to Segre, Fana, and actually it was successfully applied to Iskovsky-Hetmanin. And the advantage of this method is that it works in all cases. I recall that it was classical theorem of Segre, and which was reproved by Manin, that cubic surface in P4, P3, of a non-closed field, which satisfy the condition Picard number is one, and one-dimensional, is not rational. Moreover, its group of birational automorphism admits a very good description. So first method was applied to this class. And then Iskovsky-Hetmanin applied this for quartic in that one. And later it was applied in many cases by Iskovsky student, for example, Puchlikov, in huge class of algebraic varieties. And Chiltsov and Shramov actually extended this to this one. So this looks very universal. But actually, it's too complicated. in fact, we have to analyze singularities of linear systems. For example, we suppose that there is some birational map. It's given some linear system. And basic idea is to analyze singularities of this linear system and get contradictions in some cases. Another one is intermediate Jacobian. but it's very restrictive. It works only for the Z class for algebraically closed varieties, basically over a complex number, but there are some generalization, but quite restrictive class. There are another one very particular, for example, torsions in this group. Also, unverified Brayer group, and so on.
Which is more or less the same.
More or less, yes. of course, in this case, we have some other invariants, for example, fixed points of some element. fixed point loss, suppose it is not some component, there is some divisorial component which is not covered by rational curves. Then such a component cannot disappear after birational transformations. So this is invariant, but of course it can be applied only here. There is one so semi-classical invariant which is looks like as follows. We can look at this group H1J. Group homology of Picard. This was actually for varieties over non-closed fields. It was computed in many cases by Manian in his book Cubic Forms, and Voskresensky applied this computation for algebraic theory. But it turns out that it works also in geometric case very well. First of all, I would like to say that, for example, these two invariants seems to be very related to each other. This group is birational invariant. Suppose we have a smooth model, and the group acts, on a variety, so it acts on the Picard group. In for varieties of a non-closed field, this should be a Galois group. Then it's easy to see that it is birational invariant.
I mean, 1, 2, and 3, these are ways to distinguish varieties of they are rational or not.
Yes, yes. And this also. Actually, this is continuation. It's 4 and maybe let's be 5. This some invariants which can distinguish. Actually, you see that this all these invariants are looks quite different. So it means that philosophically we have no unified approach to birational classification. Yes, of course. It was said, yes. Of course. But anyway, both of them can be applied to very restricted class of varieties. You see, it's okay. quite recently, we remarked that, for example, these two invariants are very close to each other. This theorem it was remarked by Bogomolov and myself. It looks like this. Suppose X is projective surface. And we have group action here. Find a group X here. And then, as I told it, we have an invariant like this. Suppose that the group is cyclic, group of prime order, for simplicity. And then we have this invariant. Of course, this should be of this form. But it turns out that we have this power like this, where J is a genus of this fixed point locus. J on X. Of course, this locus can have many components, but it's easy to show that we have only if there is such a component that is unique. So if there is a component of positive genus, then we have formula like this. If no such a component, this should be zero.
Connected component or irreducible component?
Irreducible. Of course, genus. We have genus of irreducible. That's the right question. Isolated, no. Isolated, I should consider like genus zero. Because you see, you blow up this point, and you get a curve of genus, typically, zero or nothing.
Maybe still fixed points.
Yes, yes. But this process can add only rational curves.
Okay.
So unfortunately, our proof is not very perfect. It uses classification, which I just erased. But anyway, it's very nice. Moreover, this invariant a little bit better because it distinguishes stable rationality classes. This invariant is stable by rational invariant. This means that if we have two group actions, such that there is equivariant by rational map from here to here, then this invariant coincide. So this is invariant a little bit better. And actually, this shows that all this listed four classes of involutions are not stably but rationally equivalent. But there are still open questions here, because this is discrete invariant. But in these families, we have a family of involutions. They are parameterized by curves of corresponding genus. For example, Geyser involutions are parameterized by non-hyperelliptic curves of genus 3. still, there are a lot of questions here. Okay. Another question to discuss here is that suppose we want to say something about a group of birational automorphisms or Cremona groups. Look at group of birational automorphisms of X, where X is some rationally connected variety. how big is it? Actually, if as I told that X is Pn, this is infinite dimensional group. Cremona group. So it's very far from being linear, but in some sense this is very close. Let me give you a couple of definitions. It says that it's abstract definition. Suppose we have a group gamma. We say that this group is Jordan. If any finite subgroup here has normal abelian subgroup of bounded index A, where the constant depend on only on J. classical example which justifies this definition is Jordan theorem, which says that linear group GLN over, say, complex numbers is Jordan. It turns out that it was a question of Sir. He asked the same question about Cremona group. So now there is a theorem which was proved quite recently by Shramov and myself. It says that group of birational automorphisms. X is rationally connected. Is Jordan modulo of some conjecture is standard conjecture of minimal modulo. BAB conjecture. BAB is Borisov-Alexeyev-Borisov conjecture that says that in fixed dimension, the family of all Fana with terminal singularities, Fano varieties, is bounded. It means that it belongs to some algebraic family. This conjecture is known in dimension 2. The Lopetz variety belong to 9 families, 10 families. And in dimension 3, proof. For example, Del Pezzo surfaces.
No, in principle, what does it mean?
For example, Hilbert scheme. So Hilbert polynomials are bounded. Mm-hmm. So they belong to some finite number of irreducible. They are parameterized by finite number of irreducible algebraic varieties. Okay. It's proved in dimension less or equal to 3. And also, it's known, this conjecture is known under additional assumption that this is smooth. If you consider smooth finites, then they belong to algebraic family. So this supports conjecture in general. Yes, of course we can formulate it maybe possibly in positive characteristics, but this is over algebraically closed. But of course, if you want to prove it, this on this, of course you should prove it over algebraically closed. For arbitrary field, it's an easy consequence. This is one of the application of general technique. Let me give another one, and then I can say something about proofs. Another one, again, I need to give a definition. Definition was proposed again by Sir. We say that some group, gamma, abstract group, satisfies bounded finite subgroup property if for any finite subgroup here, its order is bounded by some constant. Of course, this is much stronger than that one. So orders of finite subgroups are bounded. Example again is given by classical theorem of Minkowski. It says that J ln Z satisfies this property. And again, sir asked a similar question about even more general about a group of birational of two automorphisms of arbitrary varieties, but it can be posed in purely algebraic terms. Question. He asked, consider the field K over Q is finitely generated. Is it true that automorphisms of this field satisfy this property? Orders of finite subgroups is abounded, like in Minkowski theorem, mm-hmm. Classical one. actually, answer is yes, again, modulo BAB. So here, answer is yes, without any assumptions in dimension up to 3. And the same is here. This is just question, and the theorem is again Shramov and myself. It says that answer is yes. So. Modulo BAB. Yes?
Предположим, что K это поле рациональных чисел.
Да.
В этом случае это все равно известно или нет?
Поле рациональных чисел?
К совпадает
с Q. Ну тогда нет нетривиальных автоморфизмов. И тогда нет нетривиальных автоморфизмов. Если они равны. The field. For example, if this is algebraic fields of algebraic numbers, this is Galois group. So it's finite group. So it's interesting question here. So if transcendence degree, this is the most important thing. Of K over Q less or equal to 3, then no assumptions needed. Okay, and one more comment here that this is this group is Jordan. Moreover, this is uniformly Jordan. So the constant doesn't depends only on the dimension. The constant doesn't depend on the variety itself. Okay. The strategy is standard. As I told you, that what we want. We want to apply equivariant MMP. So suppose we have a subgroup which is finite. Then we can make it acting on variety X, such that this is projective. This for finite group is this exercise in algebraic geometry for students. And then we can make equivariant resolution of singularities and make this variety smooth. This is not an exercise. And then we run equivariant MMP. What we get modifier space, this section of the group here, equivariant one. And what we get here, actually there are two essentially different cases. When that is a point, then y is a funner. And then we apply BVB. We need BVB on this. More fiber space. This is variety has a fibration, is general fiber, Mori. Okay. this is not interesting. But if the base is non-trivial, this is much more interesting thing. What then we apply induction. Then it's again, since our total variety is rationally connected, this is rationally connected variety. And we look for a proper invariant subvariety here, which is rationally connected again, which is not proper. And invariant. Of course, this is very, very rough because technically it's a little bit more complicated. On some step, we reduce the group. We replace group with smaller group to find this for such a variety. But we have to control this reduction, actually, the index of the group. This is by induction. But once we have such a variety, for example, fixed point, we take proper transform, just pull back. And we get invariant rationally connected subvariety here. And we continue this thing step by step until we get invariant point. Once we have invariant point, we have group action in the tangent space, which is faithful. And then we apply standard Jordan theorem. but this is, of course, a very rough idea. So situation is here is quite parallel to situation with linear groups, finite linear groups. It was some activity.
Explain how to deduce your conjecture from MMP
and this one?
Yeah.
This is the same. Actually, it is the same basically, but we have to consider all the varieties, not necessarily rationally connected. We have a model of this guy. Some variety defined over some field, field K, which is algebraic closure of Q in K, in this one. But Q over K, this extension is finite. And we actually we can run the same program. We have a group action here. And we run MMP. Now we are not saying that variety is rationally connected, so we have two possibilities. When X is, if it's rationally, X is has a Mori fiber space, either O minimal model. So KX is an F. this one is completely parallel to that one, except for here we work on the some number field, so everything is finite. So we basically we apply Minkowski theorem everywhere. For example, we have a fana defined over number field, so. Once this fana is fixed, we have action of our J in on the space of multiple anticanonical sections. Something like this. And then we apply Minkowski theorem. Here, of course, again, we have several possibilities. For example, for varieties of general type, the group is finite. In otherwise, we have again Albanese reduction and so on. For Albanese reduction, we have action on the algebraic torus and so on. So we have applying several reduction, we either get a statement or reduce the dimension. So basically, it's like this, but technically, it's not so easy. It's not okay. Go back here. Actually, here this activity is parallel to of classification of finite subgroup in Cremona is quite parallel to some classical activity, classification of finite lineate groups. So up to some dimension, it's quite reasonable. Then it becomes crazy. The same with Cremona, but much more much more faster. In principle, it's possible to classify finite subgroups in Cremona too. It was done by Dolgachev and Inskovskich, basically. But even for Cremona 3, distinction becomes crazy, but replacement of classification, because we need some maybe principal result. Principal result is something like this. So in fact, this group admit classification modular abelians, abelian groups. Modular abelian, they admit classification. Maybe that's all. This more or less complete answer is in all dimensions. Okay, so I have to finish. Thank you.